Well, good day, everybody. Back to today to talk about lean hogs. You know, we've got the soybean market getting hit a little bit here today, so we've got bean oil backing up, and then obviously that might flow over into ease soy meal prices. So that could be stemming the tide, I think, a little bit today in lean hogs. We're a little easier as I come to tape here, but nothing too dramatic. But I think it's worth noting that we've got other things happening around us. Those things could obviously affect our prices. So, you know, there was a time where you could be a single product person. And look, I know my father was a corn guy, right? But now, as the market is so much bigger and the money that is involved with the market, you have to see how these flows may affect what you're trading. So you kind of have to know what's going on around you. And that's why I mentioned these other things, because they can have an impact on what you're trading. And here we're talking about lean hogs. So again, a little easier as we go to tape today, but nothing too dramatic. But we're kind of in a box here, right? Like 67 is going to be the resistance, 63 is going to be support. And you might find most players are going to wait until we kind of make a breakout of either side of that to decide where we're going to be at. So that's something I think is pretty important too. Look, I say that because I know the rest of the market's looking at that. I don't say that because I think we're going up or we're going down, but I can tell you what the chatter is, and the chatter is this. We're in a little bit of a box, 67 to the high side, 63 to the low side, 67 will be resistance, and then 63 is support. That's what you'll hear on the street, but that's interesting to think that that's, or at least to know that that's what other players are looking at. And then lastly, more outside news, the dollar's been stronger, and the dollar's been stronger because we're getting a little bit more second wave-ish headlines coming out of Europe as far as the coronavirus goes. And that in doing so, that might slow the economy, i.e. slow demand. So that's made the dollar stronger. And the dollar being stronger is going to slow our foreign demand, right? So there's a little bit of that built into this too. So outside markets are lower with the dollar being stronger. But then also we've got this box that we're taking a look at. So lots to kind of take on board. We'll see how the weekend affects everything. But right now I'm going to tape and talking to you all. It looks as though we're just a little bit easier holding in there, but definitely on the negative side for today.